If you're a multifamily buyer submitting an off-market offer through a broker, should the buyer pay that fee? Should the seller pay that fee? I got you covered. Stick around. Let's tackle this one. Let's go. I was recently on Shane Melanson's podcast called The Investing Advantage, and Shane has a brokerage background as well. So he asked me who should be paying the fee in that scenario. Take a listen.
So let me ask you this, because this is where, and I know it's a gray area, but I'd want to get your perspective on it. Because I think as an investor, if you're going to do that, and I've done it myself, because I think that that's, you know, the best way to get that credibility with the seller. Should the buyer expect to pay the fee, or is it a negotiation with the seller? What would you recommend in that situation?
Again, let's put our seller hat on.
Sure.
Right? So seller's sitting at home on Monday morning. Beau, the broker, calls him up. Hey, seller Sam, I just forwarded that email on Sunday. You probably saw it. Yeah, Beau, I saw that. Well, listen, you know, they're looking to turn an offer. I've done three deals with these guys. They're a real deal. And then I say something like, hey, and by the way, you know, when they turn in an offer, I just want to kind of get the fee thing out of the way. Does 1% sound good? Does 2% sound good? You know, like, I'm in his graces. I brought him the deal. He didn't ask me. He ain't selling it. This is something that came in out of the blue to a seller for the benefit of not going to market and exposing it to the world and getting 15 offers. At minimum, the buyer should be paying the broker. Now, is it okay for the broker to throw in there or add on to the price, the fee? Like, the broker could call up the seller and say, hey, whatever the price is we agree to,
yes,
my buyer is fine with adding on to that the fee he's going to pay me, so it doesn't cost you anything. That's one way to do it.
That's, yeah.
But I think the broker and the buyer should have an agreement in advance. This is what you're going to pay me. Because I think if you can turn that in the LOI up front, that broker is paid by the buyer, it just makes you look that much better.
Yeah, I agree.
It really does.
And I think, and the reason I brought it up is because often, especially new investors, they shy away from the commission conversation. And I can tell you, working with my father-in-law, one of the first things he does is he is trying to get a lay of the land. Do you have it listed? Is it exclusive? Who's paying your fee? Right. Like, just, let's just get the professional terms out of the way so that there's no misunderstanding. Because I think sometimes what happens is, you know, you get too far down the road and now there's this tension, if you will, right?
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Often a broker is going to be the one that raises it. But I think you as a buyer, or in this case, like the investor, raising it first, I think actually shows more credibility.
To me, it's just not a tough conversation. It's an mm-hmm. expense. You know, this is part of the deal. And, yeah. I think brokers and investors owe each other the clarity so they can plug it in their pro forma and take into consideration. And so newer investors, if you're listening, have that conversation. It's not a big deal.
When you find that rare seller who's willing to entertain an off-market offer, you want to make your offer as enticing as possible. You want to make it easy for them to say yes. I appreciate you taking a listen. If there was some value in this video, please give me a like down below. Make sure you subscribe and hit that notification bell right next to it so you're aware of my videos each week. See you on the next one.